Hello learners, welcome to the D.El.Ed program of Environmental Studies. I am Professor Manju Jain, former head Department of Elementary Education, NCERT. Today I am going to discuss a topic, formative and summative assessment, making them as an assessment tool. This topic in your course material is topic number 50. The focus of the present session would be, what are different kinds of assessment? What is formative assessment and what are the examples of formative assessment? What is summative assessment in the teaching learning process? And what are various examples of summative assessment? What are the differences between the formative and summative assessment for the practitioners who are teaching the environmental studies in the classroom to report and record the child progress? What is assessment? One of the more important assessment is assessment as learning. So we will discuss here also how to make this assessment practice in the classroom. What is rubric and the example of rubric? And in EVS learning, what are the prerequisites for reporting procedures? We will discuss here. And in the last, what makes an assessment more reliable, with some tips for the teachers. Let's see kinds of assessment. In every classroom, there are three kinds of assessment being used by the teachers. Assessment for learning, that is formative assessment. Assessment of learning, it's a kind of summative assessment. And assessment as learning, that is the child as a reviewer or teacher as a reviewer. Three kinds of assessment we'll discuss here. Let's come to the assessment for learning, formative assessment. Formative assessment, it is an inbuilt part of the teaching learning process and one of the major components of the teaching learning cycle. It has a formative purpose. Formative purpose means it's a developmental in nature. It leads to the identification of learning gaps during the teaching learning process. Learning gaps could be at the part of the children and reflection and the review at the part of the teacher. It also provides timely feedback during the process of teaching learning to the children. It also helps the teacher to review and modify the own teaching learning process based on the needs of the children. It provides space for mutual learning and scaffolding and timely feedback. Scaffolding, when the children are learning and then wanted to improve their zone of proximal development, that it helps the children to provide timely guidance. Assesses child progress in context of his/her previous progress. What they have learned in a previous activity and what are the gaps. In that context, it's kind of comparison of one child's its previous learning and the new learning. It has the purpose of continuous assessment to improve the overall learning of children during the learning process. So the broad purpose of the assessment for learning, the broad purpose of assessment for learning is it's assessment for learning to improve the child's learning. Its purpose does not just reporting. It's a very important point here. The purpose of assessment for learning is not reporting. So what is the main purpose of assessment for learning? Assessment for learning has threefold purpose. One purpose is it's a diagnostic in nature. Diagnostic means that it helps teacher to identify what child has learned and what are the learning gaps, how to provide intervention and how to improve the learning so that the criteria of learning assessment can be fulfilled. So one of the important purposes is diagnostic. And second important purpose of assessment for learning is to provide feedback to children based on the identified learning gap. And the third important purpose of assessment for learning is its feedback to the teacher also. Feedback to the teacher in the sense whatever she is transacting in the classroom, whatever she has designed for transacting in the classroom, whether it is practical, whether it is achievable, and whether it is helps in enhancing the learning among the children. What are the examples of assessment for learning or the formative assessment? So the examples of formative assessment are not weekly tests. They are not the examples of weekly test which we are most of the time using. It's not add-on activity. It is not only the paper pencil test, and it's not the purpose for reporting. Then what are the examples? The examples of assessment for learning or the formative assessment are sharing learning experiences among the children in the class. That gives teacher lot many clues how they are reporting, how they are sharing, what language they are using. It's discussions. Discussion helps in many ways to teacher to know, to identify their level of learning. It's asking questions in the class, teaching learning is going on. Peer interaction. Class works, homeworks. Most of the time teacher are giving these for the sake of giving the assignments. But they are the very important clue for the teacher to know what they are doing activity in a manner which teacher is wanted to conduct. So it helping teacher to know the learning difficulties of children. It's a written work also help a lot for the teacher, and it is also one of the examples. Now it's the second important type of assessment is assessment of learning. Assessment of learning provides a comprehensive picture of a child's progress. It assesses a child progress based on some identified criteria. Here the purpose is not just knowing or diagnosing or providing intervention. Now it is a some kind of decisive. You wanted to know what child has learned. So its purpose is just more important for the reporting purpose. Focuses on what the child has learned. As I already discussed with you here, it is conducted after the completion of a unit or theme. Any topic which is going on in the classroom, a teacher wanted to know now what are the major achievable points. So based on some learning outcomes, that is the criteria, she could able to know what is the level of learning. The data of assessment of learning obtained need to be kept in portfolio because that data is useful for the reporting purpose. A record to be maintained for reporting a child progress. That data is also basically recorded. So the assessment of learning is not the mere segregated child's behavior record. It's not the addition of the cognitive skills and personal social abilities. And also it is not the diagnostic in nature. So what is the assessment of learning? So some of the examples of assessment of learning, which many teachers or in the environmental studies teachers are using, like a paper pencil test, that is the written activities given to the children, oral work, group work, experiments, assignments, projects. These are some examples. Here I would like to address to the teachers that The assessment practices, we are mainly focusing on the paper pencil. So here, caution for all the practitioners, that we know that children are learning through many ways. So our assessment should be very, very comprehensive to take into account various ways through which children are learning. So the what is the basic difference between these two kind of assessment? As we have seen, that assessment for learning is the diagnostic in nature to know the level of learning and identifying the learning gaps. While assessment of learning is to know what a child has learned against the pre-identified criteria. Similarly, assessment for learning is not based on the learning outcomes criteria, because it's a more developmental kind in nature. It's more diagnostic. While assessment of learning is structured and based on some identified criteria. The third difference could be between these two. The assessment for learning process, it is used to improve the child's learning, and it's during the teaching learning process. While assessment of learning usually used at the end of the completion of any activity or any task, or maybe task could be of maybe 10 days and could be a theme completion, can be as per the need of the classroom. So the assessment for learning employed as per the need of the children, and it is more flexible kind in nature. While assessment of learning employed to know the performance after a specific period of time. So we have seen already some of the examples of assessment for learning are discussions, questions of developmental questions, homework, classworks, and it is process based in nature. While assessment of learning examples, we already discussed that the performance, written test, oral work, projects, assignment, and these should be based on the criteria of assessment. Now, one of the third kind of assessment is assessment as learning. And I have already discussed with you, when child is prepared as a reviewer, child is able to identify own learning gaps. Child able to identify what are the weaknesses and what are the strength of my learning and how to improve. Then we can say child is a learner, and he is able to prepare for learning, to learn. So assessment as learning occurs when children are assessing their own work, their own assessment, and it's help the children monitoring own learning. It also helps reflection on own progress of learning. Its use is basically for improvement purpose, and it also help learner for new learning. Also facilitate children to ask questions, and ultimately aim is to take responsibility for their own learning, that is preparing them for learning to learn. So some of the examples of assessment as learning: the self-assessment or self-reflection, peer assessment, peer feedback, and ask questions for the new learning. These are some of the examples. So what is the self-assessment? Self-assessment is the ability to reflect on one's action so as to engage in the process of continuous learning. So why we should do reflection? Reflection, learn from own experiences, is the one of the important uses. Learn from others' experiences. It's a objectivity in assessment process, and it has the scope for further improvement in the learning. So assessment as learning process of reflection to be used by the teacher, basically self-reflection by children, self-reflection by peer group, teacher's own reflection on children's work, and maybe the record in the diary and in the record formats. So basically, if you see the kinds of reflection, it's a two kind of reflection which a teacher in environmental studies could be used. Reflection in action, when the teaching learning process is going on, there is a scope for improvement and further improvement. So while learning is going on, that kind of reflection, if it is given by the teacher or the peer group, we call reflection in action. And the second kind of reflection is after completion of the task. When you are suggesting, you are sharing activity, how he has done the activity. So after completion of activity, we say reflection on action. So reflection, as we can say, it's a metacognitive activity preparing children for learning to learn. So children are aware of and can describe their own thinking in a way that allow them to close the gap of what they know and what they wanted to learn. So how to make recording more effective? If these kind of assessment are there, what could be the recording practice to be followed by the teacher? So number one is assess the child's work during the activity. When activity is going on, that time we should record the child's progress. Make a special effort to write qualitative remarks or some description. It should not be in a quantified manner, but you must describe what you have seen in a particularly in AVS classroom. Prepare child profile, which a teacher must maintain a profile which give the holistic picture of different kind of whatever he has seen, some incident, some narrative the children have given. So it's a description well written could be a right way to record the progress or the performance. Record regular observation rather than doing this recording once or two times in a year. So all these should be maintained in portfolio. So we have already discussed in our previous presentation, there are some of the recording procedures like teacher diary, anecdotal records, rating scale, checklists, observation schedule, and portfolios. These are some of the important recording procedures being used by the teacher in EVS classroom, and some of could be like portfolio, could be sharing, reporting purpose also. So what is the criteria if the some activity going on in the class and many a time it's not for the assessment purpose in terms of the marks? So teacher must maintain the rubrics. The rubrics could be two kinds. It could be the developmental in nature, and if the rubric is prepared for assessing the child's progress, it's a developmental kind in nature. So broadly, these two kind of rubrics, developmental and holistic rubric, which has the summative purpose. Some of the examples I am showing here, the developmental rubrics, where purpose is, say for example, improvement in the language efficiency or in a communication skill or some experimental activities. So the some criteria of assessment we identified for the activity which we are assessing, and some level of participation in that manner, and what should be the basis of identifying the level of participation, a teacher must decide and identified. So what makes an assessment more reliable or more valid and more very user friendly? Basically, the assessment makes, there are four important features of assessment. One of the important features of assessment is assessment tools, they are the valid. It should be valid in nature. Valid means relevant to the EVS learning, whether it has the truthfulness or not. Truthfulness means if we are assessing the objective of EVS, whether it is really assessing the objectives, that is the truthfulness of the tool. So this is the one important feature of the EVS assessment tool. The second important assessment tool feature is the it's reliable. Reliable means it's a consistency. Consistency means if teacher is using through two or three times, almost the assessment is more or less same. That we can say the reliability of the tool. And the third characteristic of the assessment tool is the fair. It preferences of every child assessment will be there. It's not biased in nature. And the last feature is the flexibility. It's a flexibility in terms sense that relevant in a range of teaching learning context. In various contexts, if the tool is used, we say it's a flexible in nature. So the reporting purpose in primary classroom in environmental studies, it's a reflection by the teachers on the child work. It's communicating feedback, sharing the assessment of the children. It's also sharing child's progress with parents. This is also the purpose of the reporting. And also teacher's own reflection, which she has done in the class for further improvement, replanning, revisiting, redesigning and redevising the teaching learning process. So what are the tips? If you are a teacher, you are a practitioner, what are the tips for you to make the assessment more feasible, more user friendly? So one of the tips for you, that the clarity on why you are assessing a child. It's not just sake of assessment, but purpose should be very clear. Are you assessing for the diagnostic purpose or are you assessing for reporting purpose? It should be very clear. The purpose is not labeling children. X child is A level, Y child is B. No, this is not the purpose of assessment. Assessment should be used in a variety of ways. It so that the holistic assessment of child progress could be done. Then it could be next point which you can consider for the tips for you being a practitioner. Collected information about the child should be objective. There should not be any biasness in the recording and reporting. Then another tips for you, not to make the negative statements. Most of the time teacher are saying, no, you can't learn this thing. That has that derogative statement, you know, that for that on children it has a great impact, and most of the time it demotivates children a lot. So we should very, very cautious. If you would like to address some delimitation or some severe learning gap, then you must internalize, you must identify how such statement should be given to the children. It should not be in classes going on. Maybe in a personal way, you must identify how to share with the child or with the parents. And suggestion and feedback should be given in a very, very simple language, because sometimes a terminology which we use, it's a complicated. It's not understandable by the parents or maybe the elders or even by the child. So it's a kind of language which should use, which is very, very user friendly. They could able to know what has written and how we should go about it. And always suggestion should be given in a constructive manner rather than just a vague statement. It's a good, average, very good, which has no serve purpose. So in a nutshell, we can say in this session, we have discussed the various kinds of assessments, assessment for learning, assessment as learning, assessment of learning, and we have also discussed here what are the different uses and what are these assessments, what are the uses of these assessment, what are the various examples of these assessments, and how these assessment should be used by the teacher so that she can diagnose the learning gap, she can make some remediation plan or for intervention plan, and she should report the progress of children very objectively. Thank you very much.